Welcome guys to my guide on how to install the Shades of Iron mod with all requirements, respectively the magic spells and the random encounters rework mod. First of all, I have to tell you that you can use these mods without each other, but of course I recommend to use them together because it makes the game so much more fun and the mods harmonize pretty well with each other, so don't miss on that guys. Okay, now before we install the mods, we gotta download the mod limit fix first. This will ensure that your game doesn't break when you install too many mods, so just take this as a requirement for all mod installations. And after downloading, we're going to our Witcher 3 main directory, bin x64, and put the mod limit patcher inside it. Now run the patcher and this message will pop up. Now we're fine, so we can install our Shades of Iron mod. On the Nexus page you can find the main file, the New Game Plus patcher, which you need for NG Plus of course, and some optional NPC replaces. But these are outdated, so I'm coming back to that later on. After downloading, open the Shades of Iron archive, go to the folder inside and extract its content to the Witcher 3 main directory. Now if you want to use this mod in NG Plus, you'll need the New Game Plus patch as well, so open the archive and extract the folder to your Witcher 3 mods folder. Okay, now we'll have a look on the character replaces, which you can find in the Mediafire library that I linked in the description. These are the newest versions of the replaces, and inside the archives you can find screenshots of the versions so that you can see what you're installing. I personally just took the Crimson Warden replacer for Ciri, and after downloading open the archive, and inside the archive you can find a pretty detailed readme with all installation instructions that you need to know. The dev asked me to point this out bold and big, so
read the readmes,
please. Okay, now I only want to have the alternate outfit, so I open the alternate folder and extract the mod folder to my Witcher 3 mods folder. Well, now we can move on to the Magic Spells mod, which is pretty easy to install. On the Nexus page you'll find the main file and some optional compatibility patches for other mods. So if you're using one of the listed mods, please make sure that you also install the required patch for it. Fortunately, I only need the main file, so after downloading we open the archive and extract the three folders to the Witcher 3 main directory. After that, open the input setting text file, and here you can read where to copy these key bindings. Okay, so we copy all these lines out of here. And now we're going to our documents, Witcher 3, and open the input setting file. Here we make a paragraph first to have room for the text and paste it all to the very beginning. Just make sure that there's a space between the base all the text and the pasted text, like you see in the video here, and you should be fine. Now save the file and we're done with the Magic Spells mod. Now let's come to the Random Encounters Reworked mod, which has pretty many requirements, so open all requirements in new tabs and download the rare main file. After that we're going to the community patch base, which only has one main file to download. Now Now to the Bootstrap and Utilities, which has two files to download that are marked here. Now we're going to the Shared Imports, which also has only one main file to download. Okay, and now that we downloaded everything, we'll have a look on the community patch base first. Inside the archive, you find two folders, and we extract these to our Witcher 3 main directory. Just replace files when prompted and everything is gonna be alright. Good, now we're coming to the Bootstrap. At first we open the mod Bootstrap version 0.4.1 and extract the two folders to the Witcher 3 main directory again. Now we're going to the mods folder inside our archive, open the mod Bootstrap folder and the mod Bootstrap input setting file inside it. Now we gotta copy the key bindings out of the file again, but this time we need to paste it to the very end of the input setting file located in Documents Witcher 3. Okay, so we open the input file again. Scroll down to the very end and paste the lines right below the tutorial pop-up. We're good now, so you can save the file and we're coming to the next step. Now open the mod Bootstrap registry archive and just copy the mods folder to the main directory. Now the same procedure with the shared imports archive. Just open the archive and extract the mods folder to your main directory and you should be fine. Okie dokie, now we can finally install the rare mod, which is also pretty easy. Just open the archive, open the rare folder inside it and extract the three folders to your main directory. Now we're done with that and we can run the game. If script errors appear, you can usually solve the problem by using Script Merger, and if you don't know how to do that, I'll link my quick guide in the info box here. Okay, now in the main menu, I'll check my DLC stuff first to ensure that everything I installed is set to on. Good, now I'll show you the two ways to get the Shades keys for the hidden chests. The first method is to start a completely new game, which will give you all keys automatically. And now that you entered White Orchard, you can find the keys in your quest items inventory. The second way to get the keys is needed when you want to continue a save game or when you are in New Game Plus. Here you need to use the console command Shades keys to get them. You can find all Shades related commands in the article section on Nexus here. Okay, now we have a look on the mod menus. Go to Options, Mods, Magic Spells, and here you can set pretty many values to your personal likings. I just set everything to the default values here to save you a little time, and the rest is just up to you. Now we're going to the rare menu. And here I personally set the most things to hard because I want some additional action. But if you're new to the game, I'd recommend to use the easy settings first. And of course you can play around with these values as well. So it's all up to you which encounters take place and which do not. Okay, well guys, that's quite it. Leave a like and subscription if you want to support my channel a little. Of course, toss a coin to the authors, they really made a great job and I can't tell how much I appreciate it. So thank you guys. And catch you guys next time.